Along the Fraser River, situated firmly between Delta and Richmond, sits Deas Island Regional Park. Run by Metro Vancouver, this park has become a sanctuary for people who love the outdoors. While joggers and cyclists enjoy the trails and natural beauty, they may be unfamiliar with the park's namesake, John Sullivan Deas, and his importance in establishing our community. As much as the fishing industry along the Fraser River has become symbolic with Delta, it is fair to say that John Sullivan Deas' influence was just as synonymous with the industry. Deas, a black man born in South Carolina in 1838, followed the gold rush to San Francisco with his brother, where he developed his trade as a tinsmith. Noted for his talents, he would eventually parlay that line of work along with the relationships that he would build with his employers, boat captains, and fishermen into the canning industry. After migrating north, living and working between Victoria and the British Columbia interior, he eventually settled along the Fraser River in 1871, where he started canning salmon with Captain Edward Stamp. After Captain Stamp's passing in 1873, Deas secured financial backing from investors and established his cannery in the location that would become part of Deas Island Regional Park, acquiring the land for $1 per acre. Quickly, this cannery became an industry leader, producing between 200,000 and 400,000 cans per year, many of which were destined for England. Deas' production doubled that of his competitors, firmly cementing him as a pioneering figure in Delta's fishing legacy. Deas' production was marketed as fresh salmon, John S. D. Fraser, British Columbia. Deas was always wary of the fragility of fishing along the river, and as competitors moved into the Fraser River, Deas sought to lease drifts by his cannery from federal fisheries, but was denied after objections from several British Columbia politicians. Deas remained for one more season and in 1878 sold the cannery and moved to Portland, Oregon with his wife Fanny and their seven children. Deas passed away in 1880 at the age of 42. Eventually, the cannery would close and ownership of the park would change hands, but John Sullivan Deas had changed this region and the fishing industry along the Fraser River. While we contemplate Delta's heritage and reflect on the symbols with which our community identifies itself, it's important that Deas' contribution and influence not be forgotten.